Planned Parenthood is in the hot seat. Outrage is growing after evidence emerged that the nation's largest abortion provider is selling fetal body parts.
It all started when a pro-life group released a video reportedly showing a Planned Parenthood official discussing selling body parts. That sparked protests on Capitol Hill. Now, three congressional committees say they'll investigate. Dale Hurd reports.
This video recorded last year reportedly shows a Planned Parenthood executive casually sipping wine while speaking with two actors posing as reps from a human biologics company about the aborted baby parts.
We've been very good at getting parts on the because we know that, so I'm not going to crush that part. I'm going to basically crush below, I'm going to crush above, and I'm going to see if I get it attacked.
The video sparked protest on Capitol Hill.
America should not be giving one penny to an organization that traffics in baby body parts.
Planned Parenthood's practice of brutally dismembering young and defenseless human beings is outrageous and atrocious enough. And these new revelations seal the deal.
Father Frank Pavone, National Director of Priest for Life, says this is not new, and he's seen order forms for fetal hearts, lungs, livers, brains, and even eyes.
This is horrific enough, this is offensive enough to the American people that it merits congressional investigation.
Three Republican-led congressional committees have already announced that they will in fact investigate whether Planned Parenthood is selling body parts from aborted babies. House Speaker John Boehner said, when an organization monetizes an unborn child, and with the cavalier attitude portrayed in this horrific video, we must all act. He also called on the White House to denounce and stop these gruesome practices. Planned Parenthood spokesman Eric Ferrero said Wednesday, these outrageous claims are flat out untrue, but that doesn't matter to politicians with a long-standing political agenda to ban abortion and defund Planned Parenthood. Planned Parenthood says it's only been donating the body parts at the wish of the mothers, and any money received is to reimburse it for transporting those body parts. Ferrero said women donating fetal tissue for research should be honored, not attacked and demeaned. Federal law prohibits the sale of body parts of aborted babies, but experts say the law is so narrow and weak that Planned Parenthood may still be technically in compliance. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Congress needs to do more than just investigate here. We need legislative action. Part of that video was a rather cavalier explanation of how you avoid current federal law. And Congress needs to act to end. This is gruesome commerce. To sell this kind of, it boggles your imagination. Congress needs to act to end this. This shouldn't be allowed. Well, reaction to the nuclear deal, in other news, reaction to that deal with Iran is spreading across the Middle East. While Iranians cheer, others in the region have harsh warnings. John Jessup has more on that story from our CBN News Bureau in Washington. John?
Thanks, Gordon. 2 days after the historic deal in Vienna, all eyes are now on Washington in the coming battle with the Senate. But as CBN's Chris Mitchell reports from Jerusalem, the agreement is already shifting the landscape of the Middle East.
During an hour-long press conference, President Obama defended his deal.
With this deal, we cut off every single one of Iran's pathways to a nuclear program, a nuclear weapons program. And Iran's nuclear program will be under severe limits for many years.
In Israel, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu launched a U.S. media blitz against the agreement.
I think the inspection regime is full of holes because instead of having instant inspections, say within 24 hours, Iran has 24 days to open up suspect sites. 24 days. Imagine giving a drug dealer 24 days.
President Obama says the agreement with Iran was a risk he had to take. But many Israelis on the front lines of that risk are skeptical. 74% say the deal won't stop Iran from developing a nuclear bomb.
It's a bad deal because sooner or later it's going to reach us.
The world doesn't realize that the Islamic people, they want to take over the world.
No, because Iran is keeping saying that Israel and the States and Europe has to be destroyed and everything and has to be Islamic. So they're going to continue doing everything.
But Iranians cheered in the streets of Tehran. Iranian-born Middle East expert Menashe Amir told CBN News he expects Iran to cheat and says the agreement opens the doors for Iranian scientists.
The fact that the Iranian scientists have the permission to continue their research means that Iran will continue to find better ways of enhancing its nuclear programs that after 6 years or 8 years, they will begin in a very fast way to make the bomb.
Because of this, Amir says it will cause a Middle East nuclear arms race.
We are talking today about a United Arab Forces, which will include Saudis, Egyptians, and other countries. And they may make a united corporation for making the nuclear bomb or having the protection of the Pakistanis who have the first Islamic bomb.
Besides a nuclear arms race, some compare the $150 billion in sanctions relief to Iran, the number one state sponsor of terrorism in the world, to a jihadist stimulus bill that will pour fuel on an already burning Middle East fire. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Thanks, Chris. A question about the fate of four Americans imprisoned or missing in Iran triggered an angry response from President Obama at a White House press conference on the agreement. CBS reporter Major Garrett asked the president about a deal that leaves American citizens in Iranian jails.
As you well know, there are four Americans in Iran, three held on trumped-up charges, according to your administration, and one whereabouts unknown. Can you tell the country, sir, why you are content with all the fanfare around this deal to leave the conscience of this nation and the strength of this nation unaccounted for in relation to these four Americans?
The notion that I am content as I celebrate with American citizens languishing in Iranian jails? Major, that's nonsense. And you should know better. I've met with the families of some of those folks. Nobody's content. And our diplomats and our teams are working diligently to try to get them out.
And the American Center for Law and Justice also criticized the administration for leaving American pastor Saeed Abedini in jail. Greek lawmakers voted yes on an economic package negotiated with the European Union earlier this week, meaning the nation will remain in the Eurozone. The three-year bailout plan is worth $93 billion. German stocks reacted positively to the vote, but some Greek citizens were unhappy about it. Violent clashes broke out during an anti-austerity rally in Athens. The new austerity bill includes consumer tax increases and pension reforms. Former President George Herbert Walker Bush is in the hospital after falling and breaking a bone in his neck. It happened yesterday at his summer home in Maine. A spokesman said in a tweet that Mr. Bush's condition is stable, but he'll be put in a neck brace. No word on when he might be released from the hospital. At 91, Bush Sr. is the oldest living former president. He's been hospitalized several times in recent years. And Gordon, of course, we all pray and wish him well.
Our prayers are with him and with the Bush family. May there be a speedy recovery. Wendy?
You know, Gordon, I had the opportunity to meet him once, the senior Bush. And I said, I just want to shake your hand. He said, how about a hug? And it blessed me so much, I mean, this former president. So he has a special place in my heart. So we're all, of course, praying for his quick recovery.